it was Diamond Dallas Page crowned as the new WCW World Heavyweight Champion, and DDP wears the world's gold for the very first time.
And he also wears a huge target on his back. Everyone in World Championship Wrestling, save me and you and Giovanni, I think, want a match with DDP to get the world title.
Oh, they are lining up for a shot at the World's Heavyweight Champion, but we know that next up is Kevin Nash. And Kevin Nash has been very clear. He mentioned to me that he's going to do everything within his power to ensure that Diamond Dallas Page is still the World's Heavyweight Champion come Sunday, May the 9th in St. Louis for Slamboree, brought to you by 1010-220.
New world order.
As Mr. World Class Chip Minton waits in the ring, here we go. Representing the black and white of the NWO is Big Ryan Adams.
And the NWO black and white has a new leader. It's official. It was in Las Vegas, Nevada. The Battle Royal involving the members of the NWO black and white. And the winner was Stevie Ray.
And Stevie Ray grabbed control of the NWO black and white like nobody ever had. And Thursday on Thunder, Stevie Ray made the challenge to Diamond Dallas Page. He aimed high right off the start, and DDP's match with Stevie Ray, that title defense on Thunder, Stevie Ray took DDP right to the edge.
He certainly did. It was the first shot ever for Stevie Ray at the singles version of the World's Heavyweight title. The former seven-time World Tag Team Champion one-on-one with DDP last Thursday on Thunder, and it was the second successful title defense for Diamond Dallas Page.
Of course, the first one was Monday on Nitro over Big Papa Pump Scott Steiner when Kimberly, swinging that steel chair, came to the aid of DDP. And I tell you what, when you think about DDP winning the strap in the four-way that Sunday, a successful defense over Scott Steiner on Monday night, and then a defense over Stevie Ray on Thursday, that's a fighting champion.
I think something that we have to take into account as far as the NWO Wolfpack is concerned is the now lengthy list of injuries that almost seems to have decimated their roster. Hollywood Hogan, we've talked about it all during this program. He's on the sidelines. He's going to have knee surgery next Tuesday in Birmingham, Alabama. We understand that Scott Steiner is injured. Lex Luger, we all know, is injured. He's had the problem with the arm, and Scott Hall as well. Maybe there's something to those injuries when you try and put together Kevin Nash and his association with Ric Flair, and Kevin Nash working behind the scenes with Ric Flair to gain the shot at the World's Heavyweight title.
It is awfully convenient that no members of the Wolfpack are around to get a shot at DDP now. Kevin Nash seems to be the only member of the red and black left standing.
Scott, we have important on-sale information for this upcoming Friday, April the 23rd. Thunder is going to be coming to Charleston, South Carolina. And that event will take place on May the 27th at the North Charleston Coliseum. Tickets go on sale this Friday in Charleston at the Coliseum box office and all SCAT outlets. Plus, you have the opportunity to meet the Mouth of the South. Yes, Jimmy Hart will be at the North Charleston Coliseum this upcoming Friday, April the 23rd, from 10 a.m. to noon.
Big Brian Adams, who seems to be very at ease with taking at least a backseat to Stevie Ray in the NWO black and white. I'll give Stevie Ray credit. The black and white was falling apart. There were rumors afoot in the newsletters, on the internet, you name it. Rumors afoot that the black and white was going to break up. There would be no more NWO black and white, the original black and white. But Stevie Ray grabbed control, circled the wagons, and the NWO black and white stronger than ever.
I heard those same rumors, NWA black and white going to disband. Doesn't seem like it at this point with Stevie Ray in control.
And I mean Brian Adams throwing around Mr. World Class like a rag doll here on Saturday night.
He has had his way with Chip Minton, just totally dominating this matchup from the opening bell. Height, power advantage, and Minton springs off the ropes. Brian Adams just took him up. Whoa, look at this. Drop kick. That shocked Brian Adams, and the second one took him down.
The big legs. Oh, please. Drop that tree trunk die across the throat of Brian Adams. Hang on. No. Got the two count on Brian.
You know, we've mentioned in the past that when you think of the bobsled background, the former Olympian, Chip Minton, he will always use his legs for his strength and power. Attempt at a Hurricanrana by Minton, and he ends up getting a two count on Adams.
Did you see Minton leap from almost a standing position, shoulder high on Adams? Adams shoots him in, ducks the clothesline. Minton all the way up again, but Adams, cut him off, dropped him into the powerbomb. Oh, Minton's head bounced off the canvas.
Oh, Brian Adams is just toying with Chip Minton now. He's out. Oh, spiked him with the pile driver.
That should do it. Adams quickly over, hooks the leg, and the count of three. Talk about power and talk about unity. You're talking the NWO black and white, and that man, your winner, Brian Adams.
Well, if ever a pinfall was academic, it certainly was after that jumping pile driver by Brian Adams. And
wait, now what?
Now he talked to Mickey J, our referee, first, and
no!
What was he? Why would Mickey J allow him to attack him?
Get in there, referee! Brian Adams is out of control on Saturday night. I mean, the NWO is back to their old ways.
Brian Adams is out of control. The New World Order, black and white, they're out of control. And if you think about it, that's really what the NWO was founded on.